How, I mean, Landry, as I mentioned, is such a beloved character, and I feel like Friday Night Lights, especially because as viewers, we didn't know any of you from anything else leading up to that point. And Michael B. Jordan was on the show, and he was talking about how people still come up to him and ask him about his Friday Night Lights character as if it was a real person. Does that happen to you?
It happened more before Breaking Bad came out.
Gotcha.
And then I think most people that had seen both were just kind of confused and scared.
Yeah. Like,
is Landry still in there? Or
Yeah, Todd is like, a lot went wrong for Landry for him to turn into Todd. How are the fans different? I mean, I'm sure there are obviously a lot of people, myself included, are fans of both, but is there a difference between what a Friday Night Light fan wants when they meet you and what a Breaking Bad fan would want?
Definitely in the picture taking, I would say. Friday Night Lights, you know, they're just expecting me to be, I guess this is what Landry is.
It was like, oh my God, it was like transported back. I was like, oh my God, Friday Night Lights again.
Yeah. And then I have had a few really odd picture requests. Like one, someone wanted me to sort of make a gun with my hand and pretend to shoot them in the picture. Another guy really wanted to fake strangle me in the picture. And I didn't do it, but I feel like maybe I should have.
Yeah, maybe.
I don't know.
People are pretty bold with their requests, but I think you're allowed to say no to being fake strangled. Because that, they could be lying, and that just could be the end to get into the real strangling. Yeah. Next thing you know, you wake up blacked out, your wallet's gone. You're like, that guy wasn't a Breaking Bad fan. A lot of people have mentioned that you look a little bit like Matt Damon, and at Breaking Bad, you had the nickname Meth Damon. I know some people called you that. And I did not realize this, that you played a young Matt Damon in the film All the Pretty Horses. And so how old were you when you did that?
I would have to ask my mom. Probably 11 or so.
And is that exciting to then see yourself in a Matt Damon movie?
Well, you know, hypothetically, that would be very exciting. But I, you know, my mom organized a screening at our, you know, local theater. And
okay, gotcha. So you had to go to the actual theater.
Yeah. It was, you know, really special, exciting thing. I invited this girl I had a crush on, and I'm supposed to be the opening scene of the movie, and I'm not there. And I keep thinking maybe the, you know, it was a mix-up in the editing or something. But yeah, that was a long, weird ride.
So they just cut you out. Oh, that's rough.
Apparently, there's some extended director's edition or something out there.
That's something, but that's, years later, and that doesn't count. I bet the 16-year-old that lost the part to you when you were 2.5 was super psyched you were out of it.
Yeah.
Because, like, finally, he's getting his. It also must be a bummer when you play young Matt Damon, because as soon as Matt Damon shows up, you know there's no chance you're showing up later.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations on everything, and congrats on season 2 of Fargo. It's just been excellent.
Thank you so much.
Jesse Plemons, everybody.